the horizon separates each toxic feeling. See, you call it love, but I feel it as poison. It seems antagonistic bricks have merged to build up a marriage, breathing in the same air yet burping out different sentences. Scribbled, rubbed, and constructed, structured according to the pictures painted by the difference between the sky and the moon, the sun and Mars. Your jokes, a form of delicacy, spoiled by your loud mouth full of ecstasy. Dangerous, yet I'm so addicted. Soaked, wet, marinated in your darkest demons. Hormones break loose as I lay in reminiscence of those days you serenaded me, sweet pieces. Those days I could watch your lavish lips play around with your tongue all night long, listening to you chant fake spells as you try to enchant and entice me into believing that we were a match made in heaven. Now I am yours, you have become so hard on me like a jawbreaker, and that alone is a deal breaker. You forget I am woman, I have my human needs that need to be satisfied. Your hands created to caress my body, I say because I have felt them many times before. Yet now you leave me to quench my thirst through imagining what could have been. As you speak, the pervert in me unwraps this annoying aluminium foil covering your strong dark chocolate chest. Impatient or estrogen takes my eyes into the fifth dimension where my sixth sense is switched on and I begin to see through your clothes. I tear them off you. You tear mine garments off me. Mine garments and yours garments fuse. Then I crawl back into reality and settle uncomfortably in this insanity where I have to purchase free satisfaction from my own man. In the eyes of many in holy matrimony, you and I became man and wife. In the eyes of mosquitoes in our bedroom, I became one with a double-minded one. A man indecisive, struggling to choose between a black tie and a black and white bow tie. Well, I really thought that my decision to leave you was going to take me straight into heaven, but now that I'm seeing that my vision is coming to life, gosh, I'm realizing that life without you is hell. But I'd rather be in hell away from you than be in it because of you. I'd rather protect myself from the one God assigned to protect me. You know, God was not wrong to give you I, and I was not wrong to give you my all. So just sign the damn papers and let me go. Thank you.